Quran and to the prisoners themselves, the military, the U.S. government has said the conditions down in Guantanamo have improved. Mm-hmm. I would kind of have to dispute that because when I was there, the conditions were surely quickly deteriorating. And we're now well into the fifth year of detention, being of these prisoners being held without charges indefinitely. And in June, three of these prisoners committed suicide. Mm-hmm. That's an indication.
When you were there, did you see that the morale of the Muslim prisoners was sinking to the point where they would come to this?
Suicide was a huge, suicide attempts were a huge issue when I was down there. Mm-hmm. And we were dealing with this on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. One of the prisoners, I believe he was from Saudi, landed himself in a coma for attempting suicide in protest of how the Holy Quran was being treated. Mm-hmm. There were hundreds of suicide
But let
attempts
me ask you, you know, as Muslims, that suicide is not permitted for us. But I'm saying, do those conditions really lead to mental disorders where people are just doing things they're just not responsible for?
I observe what I believe was an enormous amount of mental deterioration from the conditions. Mm-hmm. There were prisoners who seemingly had regressed to childlike behaviors and were put in a certain cell block called Delta Block. Mm-hmm. It was a special psych ward cell block where they had a 17-man psych team to deal with these prisoners who were mentally disturbed, stemming from the conditions that they couldn't take down in Guantanamo.
And you mean to deal with them? Deal with them how? I mean, having no idea about their culture, about their religion, about their background, how do they attempt to deal with these
And I
people?
Think that's the part of why the treatment down there was maybe lacking in this area. Mm-hmm. Because maybe they don't have an understanding of the culture.
Right.
But many of the prisoners were on antidepressants. Mm-hmm. Some of the recent suicide attempts before these latest suicide deaths were done through overdose of the antidepressants that the prisoners would store up and then attempt suicide by overdose of narcotics.
Now, just to be fair now, this negative attitude and torture which was taking place there, was it all of the troops or was it there were some that really, like you, just detested what was going on there?
You know, not every soldier, of course, is going to engage in cruel, inhuman, and degrading behavior. Mm-hmm. But the environment or the atmosphere that was down there led towards much of these abuses.
So you mean some of the other ones were pressured into it?
There was, for example, one young female soldier who wanted to learn some Arabic so she can better communicate with the prisoners. Mm-hmm. But her supervisor, her sergeant, stopped her and said, "You're not here to learn Arabic, you're here to guard the prisoners." Mm-hmm. One of the prisoners actually told me that before I had arrived there, that he gave the shahada to four of the guards. So, uh-huh. You know, but this was before I got there, when the guards were actually allowed to talk freely with the prisoners. By the time I got there, and when General Miller took over the command, he stopped the open communication from the guards and the detainees.
Now, when they detained you, how was your treatment when you were being detained?
You know, I was held in isolation for 76 days. Mm-hmm. Initially, I was held incommunicado. I wasn't allowed to contact my
family.
But
what's it like to be held in isolation for 76 days?
Mentally, psychologically, and emotionally traumatizing. Mm-hmm. To be in that condition. You know, at first, because of all that I did down in Guantanamo and being recognized and praised, mm-hmm. when they arrested me and threw me in jail, I thought this was ridiculous and that the situation would be cleared up in days, if not hours. Mm-hmm. But no, I was there for 76 days. They were threatening me with the death penalty, mm-hmm. accusing me of spying, espionage, aiding the enemy. I didn't know what was going to happen. And mm-hmm. then when they moved me to a super maximum security prison, the very same prison that Yasser Hamdi was in, mm-hmm. I was subjected to sensory deprivation. Mm-hmm. When they transported me, I was put in the back of this truck with an armed guard. Mm-hmm. Two other armed guards were in the front. Mm-hmm. Then that armed guard took out of this bag these goggles and put it on my eyes. They were blackened out, opaque.
And
I couldn't see it.